Hi, in this video we're going to talk about probability trees, where we might find them useful, how we can work our way through them. The main concept that we're going to touch on is conditional probability, and we're also going to make use of Bayes' theorem when calculating such probabilities. Let's try this with an example. Swaziland actually happens to be the country that has the highest HIV prevalence in the world. According to 2012 estimates, 25.9% of this country's population is infected with HIV. The ELISA test is one of the first and most accurate tests for HIV, and for those who carry HIV, the ELISA test is 99.7% accurate, and for those who do not carry HIV, the test is only 92.6% accurate. If an individual from Swaziland has tested positive, what is the probability that he carries HIV? So this question is getting at the idea that this medical test is not 100% accurate, and therefore a patient who tests positive is not necessarily a carrier of this disease. The next question becomes, well, how likely is it that he is a carrier? When we see a question like this, and really only any word problem that seems a little wordy, the first thing you might want to think about doing is to break it down into pieces. The first piece of information is about Swaziland in general, the second piece of information is about the ELISA test, and lastly we have the actual question. Now let's try to translate these into probability speak. The first piece of information about the prevalence of HIV in Swaziland is really a marginal probability. If I am to randomly pick an individual from Swaziland, the probability that they are an HIV carrier is 0.259. The information about the accuracy of the ELISA test is not a marginal probability, but it is a conditional probability. For those who carry HIV, the ELISA test is 99.7% accurate. In other words, if I know that a person has HIV, the probability that they test positive is 0.997. On the other hand, accuracy in the case of a non-carrier really means that the test comes out negative. So the probability of a negative result, given that the person does not have HIV, is 0.926. Lastly, the question is asking us, if I know that a person has tested positive, what is the probability that they are an HIV carrier? Once again, a conditional probability, probability of HIV given positive. One thing you should realize here is that earlier we're given a probability, the accuracy rate of the test, and now the question that we're posed is really reversing the conditions. This is when a light bulb should come on and make you think about tree diagrams, because tree diagrams really help us organize these pieces of information and help us work our way through the problem so that we can get at the final answer. So how do we draw tree diagrams? The first branch is always the marginal probabilities. If I pick a random person from Swaziland, they might be an HIV carrier or they might not be an HIV carrier. The probability that they're an HIV carrier is 0.259. The probability that they're not is the complement of that, 0.741. Now let's focus on the top branch of the tree. If a person is a carrier, one of the two things can happen when they take the ELISA test. They might test positive or they might test negative. The probability of testing positive is simply the accuracy rate of the test, 0.997, and the probability of a false negative, meaning testing negative if they are a carrier, is the complement of that probability, 0.003. Now let's move on to the bottom branch, the people who are not HIV carriers. Once again, when they take the test, one of two things can happen. They might test negative, and we know that the probability of that is 0.926. This is the accuracy of the test when a person is not a carrier. And the probability of a false positive, the probability that they test positive if they don't have HIV, is simply the complement of that, 0.074. For completeness sake, let's also mark our marginal probabilities. And in the next step, what we want to think about is how can we use the probabilities that we just calculated, the marginals and the joints, to get to the conditional probability that the question is actually asking about. We're going to need to keep building on this tree, so I'm going to clean up the board a little bit. These are just the probabilities that we calculated. I just got rid of the arithmetic here. Now we are coming to why did we want to actually organize this information in tree form? Well, let's say that I'm interested in finding the probability of a person being an HIV carrier and testing positive. All I have to do is follow the probabilities that I encounter on the first branch and multiply them out. I can actually do this for each one of the branches. And now let's think about why does this work. Well, let's see what I was doing in the very first branch. Probability of HIV times probability of positive given HIV is going to give us the joint probability. This is true for each one of these branches. Now let's get back to the actual question. What's the probability of HIV given that the person has tested positive? That information is still not on the board, but we can use the pieces of information that we have to get there. Now we know the person has tested positive, so they could be coming from the first branch or the third branch. And of these people who do test positive, we're really interested in the people who come from the first branch. In other words, if we want to find the probability of HIV given positive, we need to first figure out what percent of the population test positive. The sum of these two numbers, 0.2582 and 0.0548, is going to be something like 31%. And of the 31% of the population, what percent are actually HIV carriers? This is going to be a simple fraction, and that fraction happens to be 0.82. Now let's get back to the question. If an individual from Swaziland has tested positive, what is the probability that he carries HIV? This is the conditional probability that we just calculated, meaning there is an 82% chance that an individual from Swaziland who has tested positive actually carries HIV. We have gone through this problem calculating conditional probabilities, but not really mentioning the Bayes theorem, even though we have explicitly used it. So now let's put these things in context in terms of Bayes' theorem. We know that generically speaking, the theorem says if you want to find the probability of A given B, all you need to do is find the joint probability of A and B and divide it by the probability of B, what you're conditioning on. Putting things in context, if you want to find the probability of HIV given positive, I'm going to call HIV my event A, positive my event B, all I need to do is find the joint probability of HIV in positive and divide it by the probability that a person tests positive. Now we know that there are two types of people who test positive, those who have HIV and those who don't have HIV, due to the fact that the test is not 100% accurate. Since people who test HIV could be coming from either of these populations, HIV in positive or HIV in negative, what I want to do is add these two joint probabilities in the denominator. Let's bring up our little probability tree to cheat off of here so that we can grab the numbers. The numerator is simply the first branch, HIV and positive, and the denominator are the joint probabilities from the first and the third branch, getting us back to that conditional probability 0.82. I hope that this video has been useful for understanding how and when we use probability trees, how they relate to Bayes' theorem, and in general how to calculate conditional probabilities. Thanks for listening.